are a couple faith-based films opening in select cities within the next few weeks. It's exciting, and that's what we want to tell you about. And we're honored to have one of the stars from both of the films with us today to tell us about them. The films are The Return to the Hiding Place and Alone Yet Not Alone. Kelly Grayson has roles in both movies. Yay! Welcome to Real Life! Yay!
Thanks for having here, Kelly.
I'm so excited. So let's start with, we're going to hear your personal story later in the show, but so let's start with the movies, The Return to the Hiding Place. Can you give us a brief description of that movie?
Yes, such a powerful film. I was so blessed to be a part of it. You're probably familiar with the Corrie Ten Boom story.
Oh, yes.
So it's a similar story. It's basically the same story, but different characters are highlighted. So it's what she called her teenage army.
Yes.
So it's the young people who were part of the resistance operations and made everything happen from, you know, getting Jews here or there, doing the raids, the ration cards, all that kind of thing. So I played one of the young people who was her teenage army.
Wow. How did that affect your life, personally? It had to have affected you.
To be in those moments and realize what people went through, I mean, everybody has decisions to make on a daily basis.
Right.
But to be portraying young people who believed in something so much bigger than themselves, and not only were they willing to live for something like that, but they are actually willing to die for it. And that's a powerful, powerful thing. And so to get to that place of realizing what is it that these people were willing to live and die for and why.
Well, that's neat. Wow. Most of us have heard of Corrie's story, but we haven't heard this side of it. It's going to be great to see this. And we've got a clip. We want to show you a short clip from Return to the Hiding Place.
Should we pull back? We're not the ones who pay the price for our operation.
Tell that to Frank.
150 innocent people died because of a botched assassination attempt.
On a Nazi general.
We are somewhat guilty of pulling the trigger at every execution of these Dutch women and children. We with our bombs, and you with your bloody leaflet. This little bullet, 100 Dutch men and women, Hans's little notebook, 100 women and children.
Stop!
No, don't stop!
That looks really exciting. So, what do you think that Corrie Ten Boom's life and the story of these young people, what does that mean for us today?
I just think, you know what you believe. Look at other people. There's so many hurting people, so many people in the world today that need someone to be a voice for them, to lay down their lives daily. And, you know, actually, even on a more basic level, I think that's what parents do. That's what moms do. That's, you know, they're unsung heroes all
they
the time,
are.
You know, that you don't even realize are laying down their lives. But I think that's really pivotal, is to know what it is you believe and, you know, be willing to live for it and be willing to die for it.
I love that, because really we can take that to today, because there are people that are hurting and they're drowning in life's hurts, pains, and sorrows, and we are the hands and feet of Jesus on the earth, just like she was. I love that she chose to be brave. Yes. Like, we have to be brave.
You know, it's interesting because there, we can ignore things, you know, and I know that you're an activist too, and you're involved. We'll hear more about that later. But we can easily just sort of amuse ourselves and kind of
pretend like my life's okay and everything else.
But Corrie Ten Boom didn't do that. Well, we want to talk about your other movie, Alone Yet Not Alone. It's a historical drama based on a true story, set in the 1750s, I think, set in Pennsylvania, right?
Yay! Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about it.
Okay, so it is a story set during the French and Indian War, and it's the story of some early American frontiers, you know, just a frontier family, some pioneers. And they essentially were caught in the wake of really bad decisions in government, which caused the conflict, you know, between the Indians and the settlers during the French and Indian War. And it's their story. The girls, the daughters, were kidnapped and taken captive. And it's their story of faith and hope and survival.
Wow. Okay, well, we have a clip we want to show you from the movie Alone Yet Not Alone.
Father, I don't know what to do. Please help me.
Oh.
Wow. So set the story up for us. Who's your character there, and what exactly has happened?
So she has been taken captive. She's actually grown up in an Indian village. Mm-hmm. And then she's at this place of conflict. Do I escape? She's going to be, essentially, she's going to have to marry one of the braves and the chief's son. Mm. So she has that conflict of, you know, what are the ramifications of this as far as my faith and how it's going to affect me and all those kind of things. That's what she's dealing with there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, do I try to escape, et cetera. So, and she has dark hair because when they would integrate the young people into their tribe, dye their skin and their hair, that kind of thing. So it was fun. Yeah. It's fun to have dark hair.
And dark hair.
Yeah. I like
what it was the theme that was running through this movie?
You know, there's a couple themes that are so powerful that I hope everybody takes away from the films. One is, again, being anchored in what you believe in.
Right.
To see them anchored in their faith, and that's really what sustained them and ultimately brought them back together as a family. I don't want to spoil the story.
Yeah,
you can't get too many details.
Tell us the details.
Yeah. But, and then another one is just how much parents can influence their children, like the impact that words have, you know, and you see their families having discussions around the dinner table, you know, singing songs, talking about the Lord, and then to see the impact of that throughout their whole lives, it's actually pivotal within the story, and to see that be what actually brings them back together too is so amazing. Mm.
It is an amazing story. I mean, people need to see the trailer for sure.
Yeah.
They get a little bit more of a taste. But tell us when the movies open, and tell us a little bit about how we can make sure we see them around here.
Right, because I want everyone to see them.
Yeah.
In fact, don't underestimate the impact that you can have on culture as a viewing audience.
Right.
You know, when there's films that are awesome, that really have, you know, state something that you believe in, that are value creating, that are you want to see more of.
Right.
You need to get out. It's like get out there and vote. You know, you need to go buy a ticket. All you have to do is buy a movie ticket. You know, go on a date.
Yeah.
You know,
take your
wife out to dinner and go to a movie, and you're actually like casting a vote. So, if you go to SeatZ.com, some of them are Return to the Hiding Place is a limited release, but click on Bring It to Your City and tell 10 of your friends, who tell 10 of their friends, who tell 10 of their friends, and you got a couple theaters filled.
Right.
So, if you click on SeatZ.com. SeatZy.com, Bring It to Your City. And then same thing with Alone Yet Not Alone. You can purchase tickets on SeatZy.com.
Right.
So it's SeatZy.com, but we'll have a link to that on our website, so you'll be able to go onto the website and to get that information at ctvn.org. But it's interesting, you actually buy the tickets, but you don't get charged unless 500 people...
Unless the theater is filled,
and they bring them.
May 23rd.
Yes.
Is Return to the Hiding Place, so don't miss it, because it's coming up quick.
Yeah.
And then Alone Yet Not Alone is June 13th.
Wow.
That's my birthday.
Yeah?
Yay! A little kiss from heaven.
Yeah.
Yay, on my birthday.
You didn't say, Buck, we gotta go see this movie.
Oh, yeah. Really, I mean, if you're a pastor watching, if you are a high social media chick, get it out there. Get the word out, because we want great movies that really are meaningful and impact and change your life. It's time for the good stuff.
Absolutely. What's great is these are about people who live their faith in the middle of extreme circumstances.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
It makes me want to pull out the warrior chick.
I know.
Which you do your own stunts.
I do. So much
And
fun.
You did...
Sword fighting?
That's the coolest thing ever.
In another film, yes. So hopefully I'll have 4 films coming out this next year. I want everyone to see all of them.
Okay.
So check out my website, kellygrayson.com, KellyGrayson.com.
Yeah.
And you can look at all the films and when they're coming out, because they're all really great messages and super fun. And yes, I was able to do my own stunts. So I've done sword fighting and horseback riding, and I learned a little bit of lacrosse. And you know,
that's great.
It was
fun.
Yay.
It was awesome. Kelly's going to be back to talk more about her life right after this.
Later on Real Life, our weekly panel rolls up their sleeves, opens their Bibles, and answers your hard questions. Pastor Pete Giacalone continues his teaching series on the 7-Minute Word. And coming up next, more with actress Kelly Grayson as she shares her personal journey of faith. That's next on Real Life.
Mom, can I talk to you?
Sure. What do you have there, Sam?
It's my first paycheck, and I want to make sure to give God my tithe today at church.
Oh, I am so proud of you. Now go get your sister. Your dad's in the car. We're going to be late. As a parent, we do our best to try and set a good example for our children. And when we can see it working, it's priceless. It's one of the many reasons that we love Cornerstone. Not only do they provide great programming that really speaks to us, they also lead by example by tithing 10% of all the money that comes into their ministry back into our community and around the world.
Come on, Mom.
We all believe in honoring God by giving back some of what the Lord has blessed us with. It's the example that we set for our kids, and I am thankful that Cornerstone does the same thing. That's Cornerstone, and that's the difference.
Look around you. Every day, heroes abound in our country. We're surrounded by people who courageously face difficult obstacles life has thrown in their paths. Tune in each week to meet people who show there are positive, godly solutions to tough, critical situations. We'll tackle challenging life issues such as abortion, stem cell research, adoption, and abstinence, and show that every human life is valuable and precious. Join us for inspiring stories of people facing life head on.
Thanks to you, Cornerstone Network is able to provide wholesome family programs that bring the good news of Jesus Christ to viewers around the world. Did you know that your support is making a difference in someone's life? Think about that. For 35 years, your gifts to Cornerstone have provided family-friendly television around the clock, entertaining and encouraging the entire family, bringing the love of God to a world in need. Thank you again. Your support is impacting lives with the love of Jesus Christ.
As promised, back with us is Kelly Grayson. She stars in two upcoming films that will be opening in select theaters across the country, Return to the Hiding Place and Alone Yet Not Alone, both opening in just the next few weeks.
Yay.
And now we want to hear more about Kelly's story. Oh, by the way, you can go to ctvn.org and we'll have Kelly's website, the CT website. We'll have all kinds of websites there for you, so
movies.
Be sure you do that, ctvn.org. But Kelly, you're an actress, you're an activist, you're an athlete, all these things.
Yeah.
How did you get involved in acting? When did you know you wanted to do that?
Yeah, I think I'm still on that journey. I don't know. No, I am. It's something that I never would have even imagined, because growing up I was super, super shy. Mm-hmm. And I think it was probably, there was something just hidden that I didn't even let anywhere near the surface, because mm-hmm. it's such a departure for me, you know, with my personality. Because to be super shy and then go into a career where everything you do is like microanalyzed from the first moment, you know, like hundreds of people watching the camera, oh, wait, your hair, your makeup, you're this, what about that, what did that mean, you know, it's an interesting dichotomy. So I think, though, for me, wanting to impact culture, I've always had the heart, like I've always had a heart to do that.
That's awesome.
Media is such an incredible medium for impacting people. And I want to inspire people to look beyond themselves, mm-hmm. you know, to make a difference in somebody else's lives. And there's so many people who are hurting. I spent lots and lots of time, you know, with missions, and just mm-hmm. ever since I was little, being aware of, I mean, I remember when I was really tiny, giving like pennies to the little bread thing for someone in Africa or whatever.
Right.
And so have spent a lot of time in third world countries and just seeing, you know, real life needs.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been a great thing to have a perspective, you know, for just what, you know, what people are suffering. So I think that's part of my motivation, is just to want to make a difference.
How long have, when did your faith start? As a child, or were you in your teens, or were you a young adult? Or,
I mean, that's obviously one of those things that continues to grow,
right.
you know, because God is so amazing and there's so many facets of Him. So
right.
I'm continuing to grow in that. But yes, ever since I was little, I prayed to receive Christ when I was four. But I would say that as I got older, I think for me, the pivotal point in my relationship with God was probably about 7 years ago, when I like really grasped grace for the first time. Because I kind of knew, like, well, this is how you're supposed to do this, this is the box you're supposed to fit in and whatever. But I think it was more of religion than relationship, even though my whole life was like, no, this is about relationship. I want a relationship with God.
Right.
But for me, grasping grace was just the most unbelievable thing ever. Like, wow, you mean I can actually not be completely perfect and maybe God will still love me, you know, and not that I would never want to choose to do something wrong, but just the thought of God loving me, it finally sunk in, you know, a little bit, and just, and I think if you truly understand grace, if you truly grasp it, then you're never going to want to use it, or, you know, you're never going to want to, like, take it. You're not going to choose intentionally do the wrong thing, oh, God will cover it, but just that realization of God's love.
It's so easy for us to try to make a religion instead of that relationship, isn't it? Instead of having that father heart and just, you know, entering into His grace. Mm-hmm. Well, what about Hollywood? What about being involved in as a Christian
being
in this
Christian
industry?
Actress.
What's that like? Is it like feeding you to the sharks?
Is it easy?
Or is it
well, easy or hard?
No, yeah, it's not easy to find roles that I want to be involved in, you know. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, I love being a part of really great productions, and that's what that's what I want to do.
Right.
But just that the daily questions of what are my limitations, what, you know, what's art and what's, you know, something that's right. moral values to me. And so stories of redemption are really a great thing, you know. And I think the overall what the movie is communicating is the important thing.
The message.
For me, yes. And I've discovered that it's actually a lot easier to kind of be involved in from a development on, you know, just like find stories, hear about stories, be a part of helping develop stories that are really great stories, you know.
Do
and
you
true
have
stories.
Sort of a personal message that you carry with you everywhere?
Well, I hope that people see Jesus in me.
Yeah.
I mean,
that's perfect.
That's my desire.
Yeah.
And just, you know, I think there's a poem or a saying that I've heard, and it's preach the gospel wherever you go, but if necessary, use words. And so that's what I want my life to be a reflection of.
Yeah, wow. Awesome. So what causes do you work for? What are you passionate about? You have several things.
Yes. Yeah, there are several things I do. I think, and you know, back to the other question a little bit, is just, I want to be an example of like true Christianity and not, because there's so many stereotypes now that I don't really want to be associated with, because it's all the rules and it's the, you know, this is what a Christian looks like and whatever, but then you get a lot of stereotypes that aren't truly God's heart, you know?
Right.
So anyway, you know, Jesus, who actually elevated women to a place in society that society had never seen before.
Right.
Like, that's Jesus. Mm-hmm. That's the message that people don't get,
right.
you know? So anyway, I
get it.
Yeah,
it's good.
I know. But yes, as far as things that I'm involved in, I really have a heart for orphans. I always have. And just orphans ministries, mainly in Africa, is what I'm supporting. Also, organizations that promote religious liberties.
Mm-hmm.
And, are trying to stop human trafficking are some things that are really close
to
my heart.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then I just recently became affiliated with an organization called Got Your Six that helps returning warriors and veterans and their families.
Because
I think you could never give back enough for people who have really laid down their lives for our country
right.
and for the freedoms that we enjoy every day, you know, and probably take for granted more than we should, so.
Well. Another side of your career is that you do your own stunts. You're very athletic. How did you get involved in doing that? I mean, do you like that part of it? I mean, obviously, if you're doing your own stunts, you must really like it.
I do. I've always been really athletic, so I'm really grateful that God made me that way. And I mean, anything you throw at me, I'm like, yeah, I'm up for it. What's next?
Brave.
And I just love to. I had a big brother, and so, you know, I always had to keep up. And so I think, you know, anything my big brother did, I wanted to do.
What's your favorite exercise?
Well, as a workout, I do Zumba.
Yay!
Because I love to dance. And so that sort of gets the dancing and the exercise. It doesn't feel like you're exercising, because I'm not like a big, like, sit there and exercise kind of feels. Mm.
Right.
So if you Zumba, then it's like kind of both, you know?
What is your personal favorite movie?
Oh, wow. There's so many fun ones. I love just off the top of my head, The Last of the Mohicans is kind of amazing.
I was thinking that as I
that
was sitting. Right
in to yeah. Alone, yet not
it
alone,
does,
doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. And then The Mask of Zorro. It's so romantic.
Okay, on your website, there's a video of you sword fighting.
Yes.
So you obviously, I mean, that goes right along. Where does one learn how to sword fight anyway?
I just had some really great instructors. You know, there's all kind of stunt people in the industry who are really gifted. And so I had an incredible stunt coach, and he just worked with me through all those sword sequences, and it was so much fun. So much fun to do my own stunts. I love it.
That would be awesome.
It's the thing that I love about acting, where you get to live so many lives in one. You know, it's just like, okay, now I'm this character, and it's just like, yeah, multiple lives.
Where's the coolest place you've recorded a film?
I just did some stuff in Russia, in Moscow.
Oh, neat.
Which was beautiful, and it was at Christmas time, so all the lights, it was just amazing. It was just sort of magical and romantic and snow everywhere. And so that was really beautiful.
Oh, wow.
Well, you say that you like living for something bigger than yourself, and that's what you're encouraging people to do. Thank you so much, Kelly, for being with us.
Thank you so much.
You're so beautiful and awesome. We're cheering you on. Go to her website, support these movies. Let's watch them and let's bring all of our friends with us, right? It's time for us to turn to God's Word for some divine inspiration. Our teacher this week is Pastor Pete Giacalone, the senior pastor of the Rainbow Temple.